said, you've heard it's been said, don't commit adultery, but I say unto you that whoever divorces his wife and marries another woman commits adultery. In Mark chapter 10, he says, whoever divorces his wife and marries another woman commits adultery. And then Jesus said, and if a woman divorces her husband, marries another man, she commits adultery. And two or three times Jesus also said, whoever marries a divorced woman commits adultery. Now people say, no. Whoever breaks one of these least commands and teaches men so, he will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys these commands and teaches them will be great in the kingdom of heaven. Now, suppose someone takes an oath. Now, to join certain types of organizations, sometimes secret organizations, sometimes others, you have to take an oath. Swear certain oaths. Jesus said, swear not at all. Don't take those oaths. If you mean yes, just say yes. That's enough. If you mean no, say no. That ought to be enough for one of God's people. God's people ought to be dependable, so when you say you're going to do something, you're going to do it. And then what about if somebody hurts you? Jesus said, if somebody hits you on one cheek, turn the other also. Well, now watch. Suppose someone is so angry, they slap you on the side of the face, and here's what you're seeing. You're seeing stars. What are you going to feel like doing? Well, let me draw a picture, and you tell me if I'm drawing it right. Is this what you feel like doing? Here's the person who hurt you, and here's you. And here's what they're saying. And here's what you're saying. Did I get it right? What you feel like doing? Well, you may feel like doing that, but Jesus said no. Someone hits you on one cheek. He did not say, teach them to never do it again. He said, turn the other cheek. Maybe need to change this picture right here. We're at a camp a few weeks ago, and this time it was not boys, it was two girls. And one of them just hit the other one, and boy, you talk about anger. And boy, they wanted to, I think, claw each other's eyes out. No, if you're going to follow Jesus, there's going to be a whole different way of living and thinking. Whoever hits you on one cheek, turn the other also. Jesus said, don't resist him that is evil. Now he goes on. Suppose somebody takes away your coat. That's wrong. He shouldn't take your coat away. Jesus said, okay, go ahead and give him another one too. Man, that's different. He's stealing one, you're going to give him another one? Another place he said, they take your stuff, don't ask for it again. He said, if they try to make you go a mile, go with them 2 miles. In the time of Jesus, sometimes these soldiers, Roman soldiers, could force a person to carry their baggage. And so here's someone, he's busy going about his own work, and this soldier comes up and he forces him to carry his suitcases for him. Well, if he goes a mile, that's going to take 20 or 30 minutes walking, you know, carrying a load. But Jesus said, go 2 miles. Well, that's going to be 40 minutes or maybe an hour. But then, when you get there, you're 2 miles out of your way. That's going to take a long time. You may spend an hour and a half Whoever breaks one of these least commands and teaches men so, he'll be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them, he will be great in God's kingdom. Then Jesus said, love your enemies. Bless those that curse you. Do good to those who hate you. And pray for those who despitefully use you. Now, let me ask you a question. You know someone who has hurt you. Think about the person, maybe it's somebody yesterday, maybe it's somebody today, maybe it's last week, maybe it's a long time ago, someone hurt you. Are you thinking of who that is? Or have you lent to someone and they have not returned what you lent? Maybe it's a long time ago. If you've lent to people, you probably know that many times you'll never see it again. Jesus said, lend, hoping for nothing again. Someone said, I just make a rule, I don't lend to anyone because I lose my money and I lose their friendship. All better ways to do what Jesus said. Lend, hoping for nothing again. If you've lent and they haven't paid you back, what can you do? Have you lost their friendship? Maybe not. Jesus said, he taught us to pray, and forgive us our debts. You can see this in Matthew 6, in the Lord's Prayer. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. They owe you some money. They've been owing it for months. If you go to them, or you write them a letter, or you call them and say, just consider that what you owed me paid. I bet they won't. I bet you may not lose their friendship after all, you see. Because God is not going to forgive me if I don't forgive those who wrong me. Jesus specifically said that 3 times. In Matthew 6. In Mark 11. And in Matthew 18 as well. If we don't forgive others who've wronged us, God won't forgive us either. Oh man, I need to have God forgive me. I'm not in any kind of condition to face God without his forgiveness. And you're not either. We better be sure that we're obeying Jesus' commands. For if you don't forgive others, Jesus said God won't forgive you either. Now, I've asked you, is there someone who's wronged you? Is there someone who hurt someone that you love? Is there someone who has borrowed from you and never has paid back? Is there someone who has cursed you? Well, listen to what Jesus said. Watch. Here's someone. That person is so angry at you. Here's you. They have said some things that no one should say. I won't write them out exactly, but you know what he's saying. I couldn't say the words right on television. I couldn't write them out here, but you know what it is. Has someone cursed you? Has someone said some evil things? Has someone hurt you and the person did it on purpose and despitefully used you? What did Jesus say do? He said, love them. Is there something good you can do for that person? Maybe give them a gift in secret. Don't do it publicly. Don't tell everybody what you're doing. Give them a nice present. That would make them ashamed. That would heap coals of fire on their head. Bless your enemies. They have cursed you. Why don't you ask for God's blessing on them? Ask God to bless that person. Bless his family. Bless her family. Ask God to give them a good day. Ask God to give her a good day. Love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Do good to those who hate you. And pray for those who despitefully use you. Why don't you go kneel down, bow down before the Lord, think about that person who has wronged you, that person who owes you money, that person who has hurt someone you love, that person who has cursed you, and ask God to bless them. You see, that's the way God treated us. We've done a lot of sins against God. You know, our sins are the reason Jesus had to die in a bloody, violent death. Whose fault was it Jesus died? Well, it was not just the Jews. It was not just the Romans. It was our fault. And God loved us in spite of all the evil things we've done. And He expects us to treat others the same way. Ask God to bless that person. God has blessed us. We didn't deserve it. Well, we can love others even if they don't deserve it. You see, if we do this, if we're kind like that, then we'll be acting like the Lord. It says, He makes His sun to shine on the evil and on the good and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. Now, watch, here's a couple of gardeners. On one side, there's the garden of a godly man. He loves the Lord. He's kind to his wife and his children. And he plants some corn, some maize in his garden. And he plants some other things in his garden. Now, you know his garden is going to need some rain. Would God send rain on that good man's garden? Yes. God sends him rain. Beside him lives a wicked man. He's drunk. He's cruel to his wife. All of his wives that he's had. He's cruel to his children. Some of them don't even know him. He's lived in sexual sin with so many women. He curses God. He mistreats God's people. And he also has a garden. Would God send rain on a wicked man's garden like that? Well, the truth is, many times He does. God is kind to the unthankful. Next time it rains, see if that man's yard or his garden is wet. God is kind to the good and He's kind to the bad. And He's commanding us to be the same way. Look, anybody can be nice to someone who's nice to you. Watch. There are people, when I see them, I can greet them, and they're good to me, and I like them, and it's not even hard. It's not hard to love them. But can I be friendly and kind to the person who hates me, who's spoken bad about me, who's angry with me? Can I be kind to them? Yes, I can. And you can too. God expects more of us. He said, "You are the light of the world." Watch. Just like this lighthouse is going to give warning to ships coming too close to the land, so our lives are to give warning to people of the world who don't know what God expects and God requires. You are the light of the world. We're going to show them the way to live, show them what God expects by what we do. They'll see our good works and glorify the Father which is in heaven. And I'll say again, there's a greater danger than waves and rocks of the sea. There's a danger of everlasting fire. And if we'll show people God's mercy,